I want to start this video by asking you a question. What makes you who you are? What led you to being the person that is watching this video today? That's a difficult question, isn't it? For a large part of the history of psychology, this question was answered by something called the nature versus nurture debate. If you believe that you are who you are because of the result of your genes, then you are on the nature side of the debate. If you believe that you are who you are because of the events that you experienced in life, you are on the nurture side. This debate isn't unique to psychology. You actually see it in a lot of different fields too. Even though the argument is still present today, it has been largely replaced by a different perspective, which is the purpose of the video. It's called the biopsychosocial perspective, and like nature versus nurture, you find this view in a lot of different fields besides psychology. It expands on the earlier views by saying you are who you are because of three main components: your biology, your psychology, and your sociological factors. So, to go back to my earlier question, you are who you are because of a combination of factors that involve your genes, how you were raised and the experiences you had in your life, and psychological factors like your personality, perspective, emotions, and many other factors. This is a very important concept, and one that we will revisit many times in later videos. I like to think of it in terms of a recipe. I remember a while ago, I was feeling pretty ambitious and I decided to bake some bread from scratch. I took some water, yeast, sugar, salt, flour. I followed the recipe and I baked the dough and ended up with my very own loaf of bread. I wouldn't say that the flour made that bread. I wouldn't say the yeast made the bread. I wouldn't say the water made the bread. It was all of those ingredients coming together in exactly a certain order and under the right circumstances. Just a side note, I also wouldn't say that the bread I made was very good either. There's a reason why most people buy bread from a store. I mentioned before that this view isn't just present in psychology, but in a lot of different fields. Let me give you an example from healthcare. Obesity is a huge problem throughout much of the United States. Some people definitely carry genes that can make it more difficult to lose weight or way easier to gain weight. However, it's difficult to say that the problem with obesity is genetic. After all, our genes don't change from one decade to the next, and the huge increase in obesity doesn't go back that far. The issue is also a reflection of societal factors. The United States is known for having one of the least healthy diets in the entire world. The average American's diet consists of way more refined carbohydrates, sugar, and fat than is needed. We also love fast food and we love processed foods, all of which are examples of cultural factors. It doesn't stop there though, because remember, we still have psychological factors to consider. I'm sure I'm not the only person that has ever eaten more than I should because of stress, anxiety, depression, any of those psychological issues. I can give you another example that's a little bit closer to psychology. Anxiety is one of the most common psychological problems throughout the world. There is also a definite, strong genetic component to anxiety. However, life events like experiencing trauma can certainly bring issues with anxiety to the forefront, even for those people that don't have a particularly strong genetic predisposition. Psychological aspects like your personal view of stress, how adaptive you are, and other issues like self-esteem and self-confidence can also play a role here too. This is one of the reasons why medication alone, without any other treatment, is rarely that effective in treating psychological conditions. Typically, what is seen as being the most effective is a combination of medication, therapy, and societal support, which further shows the importance of the biopsychosocial perspective. One way I like to look at the biopsychosocial perspective is as a guide for healthy living. Every day, I make a point of doing something beneficial biologically, psychologically and socially. So maybe for the biological aspect, I work out or I eat healthy. For psychological well-being, I meditate or I do some other type of stress management technique. Even sometimes things like doing crossword puzzles, Sudokus, can help with mind activity, engagement, memory. And for social health, you can make a point of doing something simple, like just making sure that when you eat your meals, you eat them with somebody to have more of a socially engaging activity. You may even decide to do a grander gesture, like volunteering. I know one thing that I like to do a lot to help with that social health is sometimes I'll just give a random stranger a compliment. Now, I'm not saying that this works for everybody, but maybe give it a try and see if it works for you. Thanks for watching, everybody.